Yo, what is going on, guys? Bobby here, and today we are back with another video. So we're going to be watching round two, Stmn versus Tribe Gaming. Now, obviously, the setup looks a little bit different right now. We're watching it on the YouTube feed. We're just going to be watching it back over that. I don't have the games on my account anymore. This is 2 days ago, so I don't have the games on my iPad to just replay for you guys. There's literally no difference. There's going to be no difference whatsoever. So we're just going to be watching the games back, getting into it, and going over every single game. This series is an absolute banger of a series. Not many series is as intense as this. We're going to go over each and every game. We're going to go over absolutely everything. So that being said, let's hop into the vid and let's get started. So yesterday's video was a best of three, best of three. This is a best of three per map, but best of five. So you have to win three total maps in order to take the W. So the bans for this, we banned Max and Sprout, I believe, and they banned Stu, maybe? Actually, I don't think they banned Stu. They banned Gene and Poco. That's what it was. So it's Max, Sprout, Gene, and Poco. We decided to go with the Piper mid because we thought they would Bell mid. We're going to have the dog on the left side and then Bell on the right. With Bell in play, obviously, we're going to play Bell. It's such a strong brawler. I'm going to be going up against Corey in the mid. OG's going to win lane. Toonie's going to go down. Apparently, auto-aim shots go for bags. The regular auto-aim shots don't go for bags, but apparently the curveballs do. I don't really understand that logic, but I guess it's a thing. Either way, it doesn't really matter. We're going to be able to take out Korai over there. And by the way, I saw a lot of comments about this last time we faced Tribe. The reason I say Korai and not Corey is way back in the day when Coach Corey was really involved in the PBL scene and just competitive. For those of you guys who don't know what PBL is, there was two Coreys. There was Tribe Corey, who at the time was Nova Corey, and then there was Coach Corey. But Corey had an I and Coach Corey had a Y. So we called Corey, or Coach Corey, Corey, and called Corey, Korai. But anyways, that's not important. We missed a lot here. I'm pretty sure Toonie picked up a kill. OG trades with Tyrant over there. I get the final shot off. Corey's one, or Korai right now is one. So we're basically battling for mid. Now, the weakness with our comp is we're very fragile. So you guys can see Korai has the power up and is in an 8-bit turret. So he's just doing tons of damage. He can shoot two-shot me and Toonie. So we can't really go near anything. And it's basically a stalemate. If anything, we actually have more mid control. But Tyrant just gets all beefy and fast. And he runs to the middle. He picks up all the gems. And he TPs his way back out. So we're doing a pretty good job right now in holding mid. Zulon has 3 gems. Tyrant has gems. And their mid has 0 gems. So this is actually really good. And this works out for us. Corey goes down over there. So it's currently 9-8. Really close game. Zulon hits a trap, so he's going to put something down. Unfortunately, I get hit, or I shouldn't say something, the bag's down. Unfortunately, I get hit over there, though, so I'm going to go down. If I don't go down there, I think it's a completely different game, but Zulon does hit a really nice shot on me. Currently 11-9. We do have to get that gem. Tyrant's going to get it and just get out. Again, the 8-bit plays by Tyrant is what won him this game. I don't even think Tyrant won his lane, but the fact that he was able to just get towards the middle, pick up the gems, and get back out is really all he needed to do. So that's going to be the first game. Let's hop into the next. So going into the second game here, we're going to bring out the Mortis. Now we go inside with the Mortis, and you're not supposed to really know where a Mortis is. Somehow Corey knows exactly where I am. Not really sure how, but he does know exactly where I am. I'm just going to go up and try and cause a commotion so we can get some early gems and I can try and charge my super. So currently 3-0 for us. It's actually working out really well. OG's pushed his lane back really far. Toonie's doing a great job in the mid against Korai. And I'm kind of just, you know, being a Mortis, chilling, trying to cause a commotion. I'm able to evade a few shots over there and I'm going to push up onto Corey. He does land some good shots. I'm currently 500 health, but that's going to distract both Corey and Zulen for a little bit. Toonie's able to pick up a kill over there on Tyrant. So we're actually up really well right now. It's 7-0. Unfortunately, though, Toonie does get kind of caught out in the middle over here and dies in a really bad spot. I try and get the gems and go back. Unfortunately, they just do too much damage. OG can't get to the gems, and it was 7-0 for us. And then it turns into 9-0 for them. So that was kind of a really big swing. That was really unfortunate that happened. I think we get the kill here on Tyrant. We don't end up getting the kill. I end up charging in. I almost get a team wipe here. Tyrant survives with 392 HP. Literally one bullet from anyone on our team. And that would have been a team wipe if we would have won the game. But unfortunate, that is not how this one went. Toonie gets a really good mark over there on Tyrant. The shots are connecting. I go for Corey. I'm able to pick up the kill over there. So things are actually going really, really well for us right now. I go back into the mid. They're trying to get all set up. Tyrant can't go as aggressive as he wants to because he has all the gems. If Tyrant dies, they're going to lose the game. We currently have really good mid control. I just go over here. I try and get Zulen, but I hit the bags, unfortunately. Zulen's still low, though. Corey's low, so I'm just chilling in the middle. If I went for either of them, Definitely would have been a better play than this. I go for a powered up 8-bit in a turret, so I just get absolutely destroyed. Wasn't even close. Toonie goes down over there, and then there's not much OG can do. If anyone, if there were two plays really that they were to look at, it's Toonie's kind of unfortunate death in an unfortunate position that obviously wasn't great, and then me not going for Korai or for Zulan. If I did, we would have been able to have a basically 9-9 tie, but that's not what ended up happening. So again, we basically have control the entire game. The tribe's going to go up 2-0 and win that set and take a 1-0 lead in set. So let's hop over into the next one, show you guys what happened. So going into the next game here, it's going to be us with a mirror comp. So Bell mid, Barley on Barley, and Rosa on Rosa. Now we're pretty confident in the Rosa v Rosa. Toonie's obviously one of the best Rosas in the world. If not, I don't know if I've ever seen a better Rosa in the world. And I'm pretty confident Barley v Barley, just because it's pretty hard to lose lane with Barley. Me and Tyrant both don't hit each other, but unfortunately Tyrant does give one of his heals, like his gadget, to Zulan. So Zulan's going to be able to win the 1v1 with the Rosas. They both get a slow in. Toonie's kind of just chilling in the mid right now. Toonie pushes up, pops his super, and just goes crazy sicko mode. OG's going to pass him the ball, and again, I didn't hit one shot. Tyrant, I think, hit one shot, and it's going to be 1-1. So the Barley lanes have essentially just been nothing. I have my super. Don't really know how, because I don't really think I hit Tyrant, but whatever. I push him back pretty nicely. Tyrant, or Toonie and Zulan, this is a pretty entertaining fight. They're kind of just popping supers, shooting each other over and over again. I go to one shot over here. I'm backed up. OG marks Toonie, which gives Toonie a pretty favorable advantage in the 1v1, so Toonie's going to be able to get that kill. And they're gonna push up. Well, Corey's gonna push up, and he's gonna be able to play pretty nicely and get a kill. I'm gonna go to one shot. Tyrant's gonna go to one shot, so I'm just gonna super forward and get that grass kind of covered while I heal up. Toonie and Zulan are gonna go back at it with the 1v1 again. OG mark Zulan, so Toonie's gonna be able to get that kill. Toonie's in a really good spot. Me and OG both hit Tyrant. OG and Toonie both hit Corey, and it is now position for us looking pretty good as we have this really aggro position over here. OG's marking Zulan, trying to hit Zulan as much as he can. I'm gonna switch over to Zulan here because I was close to my super and he was kind of trapped in a corner, and when you're trapped, throwers are obviously so annoying to go up against. So I'm hitting Zulan, but I super the right side because they're both low and squishy and I want to get some area denial. Forces Tyrant to go up, forces Corey to go back, and then I just pick up the ball and super it in the net, and that is going to be the first Brawl Ball game. So going into the next game here, the comps are going to stay the same for us, but they're going to use a Ems instead of a Barley. So what they wanted to do was put the Ems onto the Rosa and the Rosa onto the Barley so that they can have just counter matchups everywhere. But we switched when they switched, and you know, we're just going to have good matchups because of that. Rosa on Rosa, again, we're confident we're going to win, and Barley versus Ems is pretty free for me. Toonie's just going to go up again against Zulan. We're pretty confident Toonie's just going to win that basically every time. I'm going to super my lane back. It's pretty easy against an Ems, although Tyrant is a very, very strong player. Barley v Ems is just not a matchup in which Ems is favored in any way, and I don't even have to play well. I just have to not screw up. I have to play patient and just take my time, make sure I don't throw. But that's pretty easy, to be honest, just staying behind a wall. We get Corey to one shot, we get Zulan low, we put Toonie back on that right side because Zulan went there, and I go back on Tyrant. We get two quick kills over there. Can't finish off the third, but Toonie's going to put that ball in the net, and we are going to take the Brawl Ball set and tie up the sets now 1-1. So next set is going to be Siege, I think, Nuts and Bolts. So let's hop into it, show you guys what happened. So here we go, going into Nuts and Bolts. So the comp we decide to go with is Bell, Barley, and Sandy. Reason being, because Bell is Bell, it's a broken brawler, plus it's very strong on defense. Sandy is really good for control and really good for taking back control, and then Barley is just crazy DPS brawler, probably the best brawler on this map, pretty self-explanatory. So I believe we tied the first spot, we do, but we do have position. It's a 3-on-1 right now on the map, so we do gain position. They give Barley the dog power-up, which is so strong. It is so difficult to beat a powered-up Barley because it just does so much damage. It heals every shot. It has so much range. It's just so difficult to beat. All things considered, we are doing pretty well at holding it back, though. OG is chilling over there on that right side with Zulan. A little bit hard for Zulan because BB did get that nerf. Don't really know why they played BB, but they did anyways. I don't really think it's the greatest brawler into this current meta, but this is what they elected to go with. We get Corey to one shot over here. I believe we're able to take him out. We are. OG and Toonie are getting a really nice pinch in right now. OG's gonna go back. Toonie's gonna sleep. Toonie's gonna get full HP and get the kill. So we now have 12 bolts. It's currently 12-5. And we're in a pretty good spot. So right now we're talking, deciding if we're going to go all in or stay put and hold position, because we do have 4 bolts. So both options are pretty possible. Zulan goes up and dies pretty quickly. I already had my super, so I went really aggro and just used it and chucked it. And then we're just like, okay, it's a pretty easy one push. Let's just get this one real quick. And now we have the 1-0 lead in Siege. So things are looking pretty well so far. We were pretty confident in that comp. We thought it was really good, so we didn't make any changes. Although we were thinking about maybe going with roughs instead of something else, but we decided to stay with the comp. So let's hop into the next game and show you guys what happened. So getting into this next game here, they're going to switch the comp and they're going to use Bell instead of the dog. I guess they realized that Bell was stronger. We weren't really too sure if Bell would work, but it did end up obviously working really nicely. This isn't really necessarily a Bell map, but it did work out. So I mean, I guess Bell could work anywhere. We're able to take out Zulan over there, so we're able to get that bull. I'm going to super that right side to try and get some area denial and so they can't push up too heavy. And then OG marks the bot with Bell super, so it's going to be a really, really strong defense. Currently 3-0 for us right now. So this game actually takes kind of a dark turn. It's actually looking pretty good for us right now, considering it's 3-0. And we have a Sandy super, but Tyrant goes on the Bell. So I know you guys can't see it too well over there. I'm just going to hide my face cam for a second. You guys can see that Tyrant is basically just, there's nothing OG can do. Tyrant's hiding behind a wall. OG's very squishy. OG just has to back up and try and hit these crazy angles, but there's just no way that he can do it. There's no way he can charge a super, and we're not winning the bot. Now they do get a bolt with like 3 seconds left, so it's really unfortunate. Now they're going to push up. We don't have our Bell super, and we just don't really have the greatest defense. We're very reliant on having a Bell super. So Toonie goes to sleep. He gets his HP back. I'm going to chuck some bottles so we can try and get some extra HP, but they're just going to come in really strong. There's really nothing that we can do at this point. They're going to make a really strong push and essentially do exactly what we did game one. Tie the first bot, which they didn't really tie. They won. They did a little bit of percentage, but get the second bot, go all in and win the game. And that's exactly what they did. So it's now 1-1 in sets, 1-1 in the current set. So it's a very, very close game. We don't really know what to do. We really don't know what counters this comp. And we were thinking the VC about what to do. And, you know, it's very strong, but it's very squishy. And all the brawlers that they play or we think that they can play can actually be countered by one brawler in specific. So let's hop into the next game. Let's show you guys what that brawler is. So hopping into the third game of Siege, we decided to bring out the one and only Siege Mortis. Now you guys might ask, are you serious? You're facing the best team in North America in the monthly finals. You need to win this. Why would you troll? Mortis, guys, is a good pick. I don't know how many times I have to say Mortis is a good pick for people to understand. I think at this point, people have just given in to the fact that Mortis can work. But if you haven't, just give in, because Mortis, it does work. I'm going to throw Toonie on the Barley. Barley's a pretty simple brawler, and Toonie's pretty flexible with what he can play. So he's basically, you know, just down to play whatever. So he hops on the Barley. He's owning as the Barley. OG's doing a really good job as Bell. As Mortis, I don't really do that much damage. There's really no point for me to hold, so I kind of just dive to do as much damage as possible and try and get some kills. We do end up getting one kill and get Tyrant to one, but we don't finish that kill. If we win this bot, we win the game. So I'm just, you know, using my supers, taking as much damage as possible to try and get the bolts and get the bot. I get a couple, but unfortunately for us, it's kind of difficult for us right now to win this. I do get a bolt and I try and tie it, but I'm not able to do it. They end up getting the bot. I get a kill on Tyrant here, and they're not showing it on the screen right now, and I'm very thankful that they don't show it, but all three of them were clumped up over there, and I dashed into a wall like 4 times. No one saw that. No one's ever going to see that, but that is what happened. So I did just vanquish, even though I should have had a team wipe. So I throw up the angry pin because I thought everyone saw that, and it was very embarrassing, but no one saw, so it's totally fine. They get a Barley super over there on that left side. We don't have control right now. The Sandy goes to sleep, but me and Toonie work together really nicely to get that kill on Zulan. We're going to be able to back up Tyrant really nicely. Toonie's going to get that super. OG v Corey on that right side is pretty equal right now. I get that bolt on the left. We need that bolt on the right to win. OG goes down, but Toonie's able to just slide in and pick it up. He's going to cash that bolt in with 1 second left. And we are going to tie the third bot and take home the victory. and somehow actually win with the Mortis in Siege. Now, I was kind of scared going into it because if we lose, we were going to be memed so hard. But truthfully, Mortis in Siege, it works, guys. I mean, I'm not saying play it everywhere, but there are times where you can just absolutely counter, and this is one of those times. So we're able to get the W here. We're now up 2-1 in sets. Pretty confident going into the last two maps, Snake and GG Mortuary, and we're pretty good at those maps. So let's hop into it, show you guys what happened, and let's just get into it. So hopping into the first Snake Prairie game, Gene is one of the banned brawlers. Gene is something that's actually played here quite often. So the meta comp is kind of just Piper, Tara, and Bo. We decided to go with Bo, Piper, and Rosa just because we haven't been playing that well with Tara recently. And Toonie's obviously a great Rosa. I like to think of myself as a good Piper. So we felt like, you know, our one tricks are kind of meta here. Let's pull them out. So 3-0 really early lead. And at this point of the game, we should have had the win, to be honest, because they have to funnel through one lane. We know where they're going to be if they're in the mid. We know where they're going to be if they're on the left side. So we know they're going to come on the right. But we do let them just walk in anyways. Tyrant pops super. Pops his gadget so he knows where we are. They're able to get a kill over there on OG. I hit Corey once, hit Zulan once, but that's not going to result in a kill in any way. And they're just chilling, coming back again on that right side since Tyrant didn't use super. They know exactly where the Rosa is, so Tyrant's going to go for the pull. I go down to Zulan and Corey over there. Toonie's able to get a kill, but it's 5-5, and they now have the lead because of the blue star. I blame Arc Brawl Stars for them having the lead right now, but that's besides the point. But anyways, 5-5, you know, we're chilling right now, but in a pretty bad spot. I'm not sure if the right side grass is still there. It isn't, so there's basically no way that we can go up. I'm just trying to get taps. I know Corey's over there somewhere on the right side because he's trying to watch over there, but there's really nothing that he can do, or sorry, that I can do to find him. I just have to shoot kind of blindlessly. Zulan's just popping off. He tapped OG really nicely over there. I'm trying to get some taps, but there's really nothing I can do. Zulan's guarding it really well. 10-5 right now for them. There's nothing we can do. We just have to go in. Tyrant has super, so it's basically chalked up at this point. We can't really win. Zulan's going to go in a really safe position back there. And although we should have won based off of our early lead, we end up getting folded and losing 14-5. So let's hop into the second Snake Prairie game and show you guys what happened. So going into the second Snake Prairie game, again, we thought we should have won just based off of the early start. Or the early lead we had, so we decided to just run the same comp even though it didn't really work out. They ran the same comp because they felt like they dominated us, which I kind of did, I guess, so it all makes sense. They get the early blue star, so they have the lead. They're going to break that right side, so they have a very, very early lead and really good position. Corey's just going to move up on the left side, kind of stand watch. Tyrant has his super, so he's going to join Corey of, you know, just staying watch. They're trying to take out our bow totem so that Toonie can't get super. They missed the shot over there. Zulan's kind of just checking things out, you know, checking where they all are. I'm able to hit one shot over there on Zulan. We're not able to get the kill, but Corey gets really low. I hit a curve over there on Corey. OG goes down, but Toonie gets a really good slow. And again, we are in a great spot, exactly where we want to be. The left side is broken, and we have moat bow mines there. The right side is broken, and there's obviously no mid, so we should win this game just based off where we are right now. Tyrant pops super, he walks into our grass. They have pretty decent position on us. I get tapped once. Toonie's moving forward, trying to find out where they are, trying to, you know, figure things out. Toonie's stepping on mines, trying to get rid of them. I get curved over there, so I gotta back up. Toonie just eats a Tara super, over there. Then maybe he could have gone forward and grabbed some kills, I'm not sure, but he decided to stay back, probably because he just popped his super. Tara gets the super again. Tyrant's gonna use it. He's gonna miss it because of the bow mine, but they're still gonna be able to get the kill. So again, just like last game when we should have won, they walk into our grass losing and they come out winning, and that's pretty unacceptable when you're playing at the highest level of Snake Prairie. So 15 seconds left. I move up. Zulan gets a really good snipe on me over there, so you have a 4-star advantage. OG's trying to get some kills. He's able to get one. Toonie knows Corey's somewhere over there, so he's trying to get the kill. He's not able to, and 2 seconds left. That's just going to end it, and that's going to send things to a set 5, which is a lot of pain because it's GG Mortuary, and no one in the world likes GG Mortuary. So we're going to hop into the games. Let's get into the final set, and let's show you guys what happened. So here we go into the first GG game. So we're going to be going with Piper, Colt, and Bell. Obviously, we're going to play Bell here. It's a long-range map. Bell's a broken brawler. Bell's good in long range. You know, the math all adds up over there. Colt's basically a mandatory on this map, and then I'm going to go with Piper. They're going to go with Nani. I guess it's just personal preference. I think most players or most teams would go with Nani, but we love Piper here at Stmn. It's a hard name to pronounce, I'm not going to lie. And we're going to go with it. So we're able to get a couple early kills. I'm able to get a tap over there on Zulan, so we're able to get that kill. I'm going to jump up to try and just get some damage, because every 1% in a normal heist game, every 2% in normal heist game is like 1% in GG. It's really hard to get damage. So when you can get damage, you go for it. We got some pretty good damage over there. We're up 29% now. So things are looking pretty good. We have good position. OG has two traps down on the map. So, you know, obviously if they step in it, we can just snipe them or something. Corey's getting some really good taps. The bell shot's obviously connecting with the safe, bouncing back and forth. Toonie and Zulan are just in an intense battle over there on that right side. Corey hits the trap, so I'm able to hit a really easy two tap on him. I'm going to try and body block it. Tyrant is going to TP. I got scared. I tried to drag my jump back. I just tapped the button by accident and I just jumped straight in the air. Tyrant's going to kill me. I'm going to feed his super again, and they're, you know, going to get some damage. So they're only down 5% now. So it's a pretty even game at this point. We got one trap down. They got two. OG is going to miss a couple shots over there. Same with Toonie. Toonie's going to go down to Corey, I believe. And everyone right now is kind of missing a few shots. I'm missing shots. Tyrant's missing shots. OG's missing shots. Corey's missing shots. Zulan's missing shots. Toonie's missing shots. Everyone's kind of just missing shots. Although Corey does get a two tap over there, so things are looking a little bit better for them. But unfortunately for them, they're not able to pick up any damage. A lot of good jukes here by pros. That's one thing that is very slept on. A lot of people say, you know, how are they missing shots? Well, the jukes of pros are just as good as their aim is, if not better. So it's kind of difficult to hit long range shots sometimes. OG gets some position over there on the left side, which is really good. Toonie hits a really nice clip over there on the right side. Hits some good shots over there on Corey. Corey overextends a little bit, so I'm able to get a tap on him. It's only a 1% game, so obviously we had to, you know, make some pressure or get some pressure, because if they just walked up and all in, they would get 1% and win the game. So we get a couple shots off on the safe. They do too, but we do a little bit more damage, and we are going to win the first game and go up 1-0. So that's pretty hype. Things are looking pretty good. You know, things are pretty awesome all around. So we're going to hop into the second game, and let's show you guys what happened. So hopping into the second game here, again, we're going to keep the same comps. They felt they could have won. You know, we won, so we were feeling good. So we're like, all right, let's just keep it all the same. I get an early tap over there on Zulan. Toonie gets tapped pretty early into the game, though. He goes very aggressive, which is good. You know, why not just YOLO and go aggressive? But they get a really good start. We miss a couple shots over there on Corey. We're able to finish him off over there, though. And then, you know, we just hold in mid, basically. There's nothing that we can really gain off of that. Toonie breaks the mid so that me and OG can tap it from far away if we have some position. OG moves up, gets hit by the trap, so he's gonna go down. The traps are so deadly in open maps like this. It's pretty rough. Toonie is able to get the clip over there on Corey, so I'm gonna jump forward and do some damage to the safe, and try and just keep up with what they're doing. Very crazy split screen action here by Brawl Stars, but I'm gonna go down. Only did 24% while they did a lot more, so don't really know if it was worth it. At least we did get some damage, but things definitely could have gone better for us. OG's gonna go down over there. Toonie goes down. I'm kind of just vibing alone. I can't really go up, but they got a couple kills, I think, as well. So it's not really too big of a deal that they went down. Nice snipe over there by Tyrant. Toonie goes down. Tyrant uses head. I body block it. Thought he was gonna TP again. He decides not to. I think maybe he thought he could have snuck by. Toonie's over there in the mid. Toonie should not be on the mid, though, which is kind of all of our faults, because OG goes to the left side to take Corey, and then things just get messy. We're on the wrong lanes, and they just go all in and just absolutely clap us, basically. We get team wiped. They do a lot of damage, and they end up winning the game eventually. There we go. They end up winning the game, and now it is the final set, the final match against Tribe Gaming. This is basically the peak of everything. This is as big as it gets for us. We haven't beat Tribe in a monthly finals in a long time. Actually, no one has beat Tribe in a monthly finals in a long time. I think it's been about 10 months or 11 months since any team has beat Tribe in a monthly. So the stakes are pretty high, but we're pretty confident. We like range maps. We like just pure skill. Who can hit more shots? Who can juke better? You know, just matches. That's kind of our style. So we like our odds, but I think they do too. So let's hop into the next game. No shade to OG, even though we got hard diffed over here by Corey. And let's see what happens in the last game. So here we go into the final game. Both teams, again, are going to keep comps the same. Corey hits the first shot of the game onto Toonie. OG returns the favor and hits Corey. We're kind of just chilling over here. OG goes down very early, which is a pretty bad sign. They start to move up. Zulan gets a wall break, but I get a really kind of lucky because they overextended and got a little excited two tap over there. And Toonie is just doing a fantastic job on the Colt v Bell lane. Believe me, this is not an easy matchup for Colt whatsoever. I mean, you're literally a Colt versus one of the, if not the most broken brawler in the game. And then Toonie just says, okay, enough of this. He breaks the wall. He goes forward. He shoots the safe. He does a ton of damage. Gets the super. Gets a full clip. Gets another clip. Gets another clip. I go forward. I die. OG gets a bunch of shots off on the save. And we get a really, really large lead very early into the game, thanks to Mr. Toonie. So things are looking really good right now. 1:30 left. So we're kind of like, okay, good start, boys. All we really need to do is hold. Toonie gets a really nice clip over there on Tyrant. I just have to hit one shot. I'm able to hit it. So things are looking pretty good. I want to just break the entire wall over there. So I move forward, I break the wall, and now things are totally open, which makes things a lot easier for us to work with. Toonie's doing an amazing job over there on the left. Tyrants get hit by the trap. He's going to survive at one shot. Zulan's also going to survive at one shot. And Corey is also very low and is going to survive, which kind of sucks because we could have gotten some damage if we just got one kill. Corey survives at 6 HP. I get a kill on Zulan. OG gets a kill on Corey. So we get some position here. OG's just shooting the safe. I probably also should have just shot the safe, but I wanted to kill Tyrant. Got a little over aggressive. Then Tyrant hits me with a fat 2900 and just absolutely claps me. Toonie goes down. I respawn. I just walk into Tyrant again. Tyrant's just absolutely popping off, doing a ton of damage. And they're just playing really, really well. And, you know, trying to come back. Although the TP from Tyrant a little bit earlier didn't really make sense to me because they needed damage and he didn't really go for damage. He went more for control. We're able to get a couple kills over there, gain some position. I hit a shot on Corey and jump back because we just need a hold. We don't need to play super risky. Toonie eats a Nani shot. So, you know, that's pretty good. Obviously, you can't TP, you can't do anything. I hit a shot. OG hits a shot. Things are looking pretty good. They get the kill over there on OG. Toonie gets a clip. He kills Corey. We kill Tyrant. We kill Zulan. And just like that, we have finally beaten Tribe Gaming. And we take the W and move on to the finals. This is a long time coming. We've been playing them in every single monthly finals since June of last year, give or take 3 or 4 months that we didn't play monthly finals because it was off season, and we have not won a single time against them. But today the curse was broken. We defeated them. We moved on to the finals, and we are going to face the winner of either Red Button or IX Gaming. It was a very intense set. It was very, very fun to play, and it was super competitive. And even when we lose against them, and it's a really fun set, or a really good set, I should say, it's fun, but winning, let me tell you, feels a lot better than losing. So I'm really happy with this game. Really awesome that we beat them. I feel like it's a huge step for us forward in trying to qualify for Worlds or maybe even win Worlds, who knows. But that is going to be it for today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed everything. I hope you guys continue going Mortis and Siege because we love Mortis and Siege. But that'll be it. If you guys enjoyed today's video, like, comment, subscribe, do all that. But that is going to be it for me today. I will catch you guys again tomorrow with the finals. I will see you guys then. Peace.